Hello, dear students. Thank you for joining Dr. Spinak Medici classes. Today, let us discuss about potassium sparing diuretic, that is spironolactone. Yeah. And remember, guys, if you learn something from this video, after watching the whole video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel and share with your friends. Yeah, let's start the class. So while talking about diuretics, just remember, we have many types of diuretics, and diuretics are mainly indicated in edema condition and in hypertension, and usually edema is occurred in chronic kidney failure, liver failure, and some anaphylaxis conditions and during severe inflammations. So in these conditions, to remove the excess fluid which is accumulated in the body, we generally give diuretics. Yeah. So in today's lecture, we will discuss in detail about potassium sparing diuretics. Anyways, after completion of this lecture, I'll tell you in detail, or I'll tell you, I'll interrelate the other diuretics also. Yeah, let's start the class. So, in today's class, we'll be seeing potassium sparing diuretic. So, potassium sparing diuretics, we have three different types of drugs. We have spironolactone, we have triamcinolone, and amiloride. We have three drugs in potassium sparing diuretics, and in these three drugs we commonly use spironolactone. So we have spironolactone, and spironolactone is a drug which is aldosterone antagonist. Spironolactone is an aldosterone antagonist. Just remember, what is aldosterone? Aldosterone is a Actually, it is a hormone which is generally synthesized by the adrenal cortex. So, in adrenal cortex, we have three different layers. In that, we have zona glomerulosa, zona reticulata, and zona fasciculata. In zona glomerulosa, it synthesizes aldosterone, and aldosterone is a mineral corticoid, and this aldosterone increases sodium reabsorption from the body, and it increases blood pressure. And this aldosterone release is commonly seen in hypovolemic conditions, in severe hemorrhagic conditions. Yeah, and this spironolactone is aldosterone antagonist. So before understanding the mechanism of spironolactone, we have to understand the mechanism of aldosterone. So aldosterone, after releasing from the zona reticulata of adrenal cortex, it will act on the cells of the kidneys. So in the kidneys, the aldosterone enters into the cells. In which cells aldosterone especially acts? On the distal convoluted tubule. And in the distal convoluted tubule, along with distal convoluted tubule, it will also act on collecting duct. So this is the special area where aldosterone has its function. Okay, in the distal convoluted tubules, we have epithelial cells, tubular cells. In the tubular cells, in the cytoplasm, the aldosterone enters into the tubular cell of the and it enters into the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, it will bind with, so the aldosterone binds with the mineral corticoid receptor in the cytoplasm of the tubular cell. Okay, and by binding to this receptor in the cytoplasm, it forms mineral corticoid receptor aldosterone complex. And this complex in the cytoplasm, again this complex enters into the nucleus, and in the nucleus it binds to the nucleus, and in nucleus it starts transcription from the DNA. It undergoes transcription and forms mRNA, and after mRNA it synthesizes some particular proteins by translation, and it forms aldosterone induced proteins. This is very, very important. Aldosterone induced proteins are formed because of the aldosterone. Okay, and these proteins will have two different functions. It increases the sodium reabsorption from the distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct of the nephron. and it causes potassium excretion. So it reabsorbs the sodium and excretes potassium. So this is the function of aldosterone induced proteins, and these proteins are synthesized by aldosterone release. Okay, and yeah, this is the mechanism of aldosterone. And now let us discuss about spironolactone, which is an aldosterone antagonist, and it is a synthetic steroid. Its structure is similar to aldosterone, which is a mineral corticoid, which is a steroid. Yeah, and when spironolactone is given to the patient, it will competitively block here. So when aldosterone tries to combine with mineral corticoid receptor, it will block here. The spironolactone blocks here and it stops the synthesis of mineral corticoid aldosterone complex. So mineral corticoid aldosterone complex is not synthesized, and further it will not bind to the nucleus, and further it will not form aldosterone induced proteins, and further it will not have its action. So it will show opposite action. What opposite action? Spironolactone, when it is given, it will show sodium excretion and potassium reabsorption from the distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct of nephron. So this is the action, and by this action, spironolactone causes increased potassium reabsorption and increases hyperkalemia. So this is the mechanism of spironolactone. So this is mechanism of action, and let's discuss about kinetics of spironolactone. Spironolactone is very much absorbed from GI tract. However, it is a synthetic steroid. It is metabolized in the liver, and it is not totally metabolized into inactive form. It is metabolized in the liver to canrenone. This is very important. Canrenone. Spironolactone is metabolized into canrenone, and this metabolic product canrenone is also active form. And this canrenone is having high plasma half-life, and again this will have the same action of spironolactone, and because of this action it has high duration of action. So its duration of action is about 24 hours. So it is every day one dose is given, and spironolactone every day 100 to 400 mg oral forms are given. So this is about kinetics, and after metabolism it will be excreted through urine. Okay, and this is the kinetics of spironolactone. And remember one very very important point: potassium sparing diuretics are indicated in thiazide diuretic induced hypokalemia. Thiazide diuretics and loop diuretics will cause hypokalemia. So in those conditions we can prescribe potassium sparing diuretics in combination to reduce the ADR. Okay, so in thiazide and loop diuretics we can prescribe spironolactone, and it is very much indicated in hyperaldosteronism due to the increased synthesis of aldosterone. It's called Kahn's syndrome. Excess synthesis of mineral corticoid is associated with Kahn's syndrome. And have you remember, excess synthesis of cortisol is called Cushing's syndrome. So in Kahn's syndrome, we generally prescribe aldosterone antagonist, spironolactone. And it is also indicated in congestive cardiac failure condition. And in severe hypokalemia condition also, we can prescribe this. And in hepatic cirrhosis, we usually prescribe spironolactone with edema condition. So these are some uses of spironolactone. And remember, spironolactone has severe ADR, severe drug interaction with ACE inhibitors. ACE inhibitors causes hyperkalemia. And when spironolactone is given along with ACE inhibitors, they both increase the hyperkalemic action. So severe hyperkalemia is very dangerous. It is very lethal. It will cause severe arrhythmia, and patient will have to suffer from cardiovascular disorders. So this is about spironolactone, and In potassium sparing diuretics, we also have other two drugs, like we have triamterone and amiloride. So triamterone and amiloride both are low efficacy drugs in potassium sparing diuretics, and they are very much they are having oral form, so it can be taken through oral route. And yeah, triamterone is metabolized in the liver and it is excreted from the kidneys, and amiloride is not metabolized. Amiloride is directly excreted in unchanged form. So these are about triamterone and amiloride. So yes, this is about potassium sparing diuretic. I think you have understood the mechanism of action of spironolactone, aldosterone, different kinetics of spironolactone, drug interactions, ADRs, and uses of spironolactone. Yeah, this is about potassium sparing diuretic. And see, if you learned something from this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. And if you have any doubts related to our pharmacology related topics, please comment below. I'll be there to provide you the notes, and you can share this video with your friends also. Thank you for watching.